All right, guys. The NBA finally did it. They copied my top 75 all-time list, except they put their own little spin on it by making it worse. No, but seriously, we've all been waiting for this list to come out. It's the NBA's 75th anniversary, yada, yada, yada. I was excited to read through this list, and I have already read through it once, but I decided to go through again for a video and just kind of talk about it, talk about what I agree with and what I don't agree with. And for the record, at the start, I am aware that they did not remove any of the names from the original top 50 list. All right, they kept everyone who was on that list on there. And so, as I go through with this, just be aware that I know that. All right, you don't have to tell me in the comments. And I'm still going to be letting you know if I think that some of these guys don't deserve to be on that list. So let's go through it right now. Starting with Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, boom, easy, deserves to be there. Ray Allen, sure. Put him on the list. I'm okay with Ray Allen. Giannis, Melo. Melo's a little questionable, but I'm gonna go through and see who else is on there and then come back to Melo. But I will say for right now, Melo maybe shouldn't be on here, but we'll see. We'll see who else is on here. Nate Archibald, I'm happy with that. Dude was a beast, pretty underrated. Six-time All-Star, five-time NBA, All-Star MVP, champion. Like, dude did a lot. He was real good. Paul Arizin, great player. Underrated, gets shit on all the time by Wilt Chamberlain fans, and to be fair, he wasn't that great some of the years he was with Wilt, but this is the prime example of a dude who played with like this was like the Chris Bosh before Chris Bosh, where you've got a player who's really, really good, but he's playing with someone who's like really, really, really good, and so his stats go down and he gets the blame for like not being as good as he's supposed to be. That's Paul Arizin. Wilt, you know, can't talk. He was playing with Wilt Chamberlain. His stats went down. He started to get older, and everybody today knows him as that dude who is supposedly Wilt's all-star help. Going on from that, all right. Glad Paul Arizin's on here. Barkley, Barry, Baylor, all deserving. This is the first one I see, and I'm just like, no. Dave Bing. Now, I like to think that I am pretty knowledgeable about past NBA players. All right. And a big reason I think this is because not only have I watched a whole lot of frickin' YouTube videos on past NBA players and done my research on it, not perfect, not the smartest person ever by any means, but I certainly believe, in fact, I know for a fact that I know more about them than a lot of people my age, and I happen to be 20 years old, because I talk basketball with other people, and other people think that every player who played before the 1990s absolutely sucked ass, and they don't respect them whatsoever. These are the people, like frickin' Flight Reacts, who think that Larry Bird, like, shouldn't be in the top 15 all time. Like, he wasn't that good, right? You know, Wilt Chamberlain and Bill Russell played against plumbers. Those kind of morons, right? I am not one of those people. I like to think that I know about past players. But when I saw the name Dave Bing on here the first time I went through this, I gotta be honest, I had no idea who this man was. I was not sure I had ever seen the name Dave Bing before in my life. And I look at his accomplishments, seven-time All-Star, three-time All-NBA. You know, he won a scoring championship, he won an All-Star MVP, Rookie of the Year. Like, that's nice, but we're talking the top 75 players of all time. I really, and again, I didn't do a ton of research, all right? I watched this once, like I watched this list once, like an hour ago, and I'm doing this now. I haven't gone and researched these players. Maybe I really don't know enough about Dave Bing, but I really think that Dave Bing should not be on this list. I'm just saying, just looking at the stats and considering the fact that I've literally never heard this man's name mentioned before, I don't think he should be on the top 75 all time. Moving on, Larry Bird, Kobe, Wilt, Cousy, bunch of easy names. Cowens, Cunningham, I love that Cunningham's on this list. I think there are many people who would make a top 75 and not put Cunningham on the list. Dude's an absolute beast, and that's even when you don't consider his ABA seasons, where he won a freaking, like, MVP award in the NBA. This man was a monster. Curry, AD. Anthony Davis is a little questionable. I am fine with him being in the top 75, all right? But again, from what I've seen from the list so far, like if there's a couple of dudes at the end who have been snubbed and I gotta remove somebody, first dude is Dave Bing, obviously, but next up is Melo and then probably Anthony Davis. Dave DeBusschere. Dave DeBusschere? I'm not totally sure. I'm sorry. I'm gonna say Dave DeBusschere. Pretty good player. Him I have actually heard of before because he won multiple championships and he had some more accomplishments. All right. I'm surprised he only had one All-NBA team, but 8-time All-Star and 6-time All-Defense team. I have heard his name before, but he's definitely not someone I'm like super familiar with. He was on those Knicks teams that were real good, but considering the fact he started playing in 62 and retired in 74, I'm gonna assume he was past his prime in those Knicks championships teams. Like, again, haven't researched him. That's just my assumption, though. This is another guy. Sorry, people named Dave. Like, I don't seem to like you on my list. I'm sorry about that. David Robinson can stay. I'm sure he's gonna be on here later, but Dave DeBusschere and Dave Bing, probably guys I would not have on my list. Clyde Drexler, Tim Duncan, Kevin Durant, Dr. J, my man, Patrick Ewing. Patrick Ewing ended up really low on my personal top 75 list, and I was surprised not more people complained about that. But, he's just not somebody who gets really talked about too much because he didn't win. I don't know. I don't know what it is with Patrick Ewing. Like, New York Knicks fans talk about him, and I feel like there are a lot of angry New York Knicks fans who watch my videos. So, very surprised people weren't mad I had him at like 60 or something on my top 75 all time. He does deserve to be here, though. Walt Frazier, hella underrated, deserves to be here. Garnett, Gervin, Greer. I like Greer being on the list. He played a pretty long career considering how long ago it was. Started in the 50s, finished in the 70s. Dude was a beast. 10-time All-Star, 7-time All-NBA, champion as a key contributor. I like Hal Greer a lot. He deserves to be on this list. James Harden, Havlicek, Hayes. Hayes is a little overrated. Same with Allen Iverson. They're both a little overrated all time, but easy choices. Like, they're still top 50 players. No way they wouldn't be on this list. LeBron James. I mean, he won that Mickey Mouse ring. He's always joined in super teams. Do any of his rings really count? Like, does he really deserve to be here? I guess he can stay. I guess LeBron James is okay. I guess, if you have him low on the list. It's like you don't have him over Michael Jordan. I don't know what that little bit was. Sorry. Magic Johnson, Sam Jones. Okay. If you watch my top 75 all-time list, I left Sam Jones as an honorable mention. That was a mistake. Okay? Like, someone should have called me out on it, but they didn't. That was a mistake. Sam Jones is absolutely a top 75 player of all time. I did not give him enough respect in that video. This man was insanely clutch in the playoffs. He was an amazing playoff performer. He was a beast. Sam Jones, 100% top 75 all time. Michael Jordan, another iffy one, kind of like LeBron, but I guess he can stay. Jason Kidd, Kawhi Leonard. Damian Lillard probably shouldn't be on here. Probably shouldn't be on this list. I'm just saying. Look, 6-time All-Star, 6-time All-NBA, and a Rookie of the Year. He made the Western Conference Finals once and got swept. Now, his teams have not been amazing. He's had some great playoff performances, but let me talk real fast about Dame's playoff performances. I don't want to go too long on any of these players, but Dame is inconsistent as frick in the playoffs. He's had several amazing series, like all-time playoff series, and several like all-time underperformances where he played like absolute doo-doo. This man is not a great playoff performer. He's an inconsistent playoff performer. I don't think Damian Lillard has done enough to be in the top 75. I would not have him on this list. Jerry Lucas, I'm fine with that. Good player, underrated. Not somebody I know a lot about, but somebody I do know is underrated. One of those, old-time players who just doesn't get talked about. Malone's, Maravich, McAdoo, McHale, Mikan. Mikan should be on here. All right. I know he probably isn't someone who would like, be amazing if he played today. Hell, I'm not really sure he could play at all in the NBA today. But in terms of greatness, I mean, this man was a 5-time champion. He was an absolute madman. I'm not sure how he was a 4-time All-Star, but a 6-time All-NBA BAA. Maybe the BAA didn't have All-Stars. Anyway, moving on. Miller, Monroe. Monroe's an underrated guy. I'm not sure if I would have him on here, though. Like, he was a key part of that Knicks championship, but only a 4-time All-Star, only a 1-time All-NBA. Earl was an awesome player, an entertaining player to look at, like, highlights of. I don't think I would have him on my top 75. Nash, Nowitzki, Neal, Olajuwon, Parrish. Parrish deserves, I don't know, Parrish is iffy. He was a 9-time All-Star and a 4-time champion. I mean, I'll give it to him. He was on the... Robert Parrish was on the 1997 Chicago Bulls? What? This man played so freaking long in the NBA. Okay, he did not really win a... He was sitting on the bench. That's like saying that Jared Dudley was a champion for being there in 2020. Like, technically, yes, but really, no. But still, 3-time champion as a key contributor for the Celtics, 9-time All-Star. I'm totally fine with Parrish being on here. Chris Paul, Gary Payton, Bob Pettit. Pettit's a beast. Paul Pierce, Scottie Pippen, Willis Reed, Robinson, Rodman, Russell. Dolph Schayes is a great player. I might have ranked him a little too high on my top 75 all-time, but, I mean, 12-time All-Star, 12-time All-NBA. That's pretty freaking crazy. Bill Sharman, I don't think I had him on my list, but 8-time All-Star, 7-time All-NBA, 4-time champ, I'm totally fine with him being on here, even if the teams he was winning on weren't exactly like him just carrying teams against great competition. Stockton, Thomas, Thurmond. I like Thurmond being on here. Thurmond was a real good player, although I feel like he gets a little too much credit sometimes. Like, I feel like if you talk about the great centers of the 60, it's Wilt Chamberlain and Bill Russell, clearly, at the top, as they should be. And then the next dude who gets mentioned tends to be Nate Thurmond. And, like, it's not that he wasn't great. He, you know, even does have a case for, like, talking about the era as a whole being, like, number 3. But he just kind of gets more credit than a lot of dudes who were his contemporaries, in my opinion. Unseld, Dwayne Wade, Walton, West... Westbrook. All right, Westbrook. Lenny Wilkins, real good player. Not sure if I'd have him on here, though. 9-time All-Star, but never an All-NBA player. Like, it's iffy. Wilkins is iffy, and I definitely might take him off here. This Wilkins, I would definitely have on here, though. Everybody knows the biggest snub of the original top 50 list. Very glad he made this list. 9-time All-Star, 7-time All-NBA. Absolute beast. And James Worthy, last of all. This is a great list. This is, or I should say, by ESPN standards, an absolutely phenomenal list, all things considered. Now, if they were to go and rank these players from number 1 through 75, or I think there's actually 76 dude on the list because of a tie, then the list would probably be doo-doo. But this is a good list by ESPN. However, if there was one dude who was clearly left off the list, like is a massive leave-off, it is Dwight Howard. Why is Dwight Howard not on this list? Dwight Howard is not just top 75. Dwight Howard is, in my opinion, a top 50 player of all time. All right? Low top 50. He's like number 49 or 48. But he is a top 50 player of all time. Why the hell is he not on this list? That is a massive snub. Give me him over either of the Daves. Give me him over Damian Lillard for sure. Give me him over Melo. Give me him over probably like Jerry Lucas. I could probably name at least a few other dudes on him. He's over George Mike in all time. I'd have him over like Reggie Miller and Ray Allen all time. Earl Monroe. Dwight Howard is a terrible snub from this list. There are some other guys you can argue, certainly. Dikembe Mutombo, Ben Wallace. Seems like defense really didn't get enough credit for these lists. But Mutombo and Wallace, I would find a way to sneak in here somewhere. There's certainly some other guys I can think of. Joe Dumars, was he on the list? I don't think he was. Yeah, Joe Dumars I would get on here. Certainly over, like, Dave Bing or David Boucher. I want to stop saying his name because I'm terrified I'm pronouncing it wrong. I really think that's how you say it, but I'm sure somebody will let me know in the comments if I'm botching it. Overall, though, not a terrible list. Anthony Davis is another dude. Dwight Howard is over Anthony Davis all time. How do you have him on here, not Dwight Howard? That upsets me. But for the most part, a pretty solid list, especially by ESPN standards. I'm pretty much happy with it. If they put Dwight Howard on here somewhere, I really wouldn't have any massive complaints. This is a good list, and good job, ESPN. You did a good job copying my formula and making a top 75 all time. Still, you know, I'm going to have to sue you for copyright because you stole my thing. But good job, nevertheless. Thank you all for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the video.